Good day, everyone. Welcome to Global Government News. Today is Wednesday, November 10th, 2010, and I am Darko. Welcome to this news bulletin where I'll cover some Big Brother, police state, eugenics, and then leftover war on terror, liberty, sovereignty news that I just couldn't cover in the 15-minute span that I had. So we'll just get right to it. Actually, we won't. I'm going to just announce my website to new listeners. I still forget to do that at times, but either way, it's www.ggnonline.com. That's ggnonline.com. I recommend new viewers to check that out. You get to learn a bit about who I am, what I've been doing in my life, and you know, where I'm at now, along with the most recent videos are posted. So that's ggnonline.com. All right. Anyways, the good thing is you don't have to stand advertising, right? So, in commercials, which is hardcore news coming at you. And this is biometric devices help New Jersey County track delivery of homeless services. And I just read this as a headline. I didn't actually get a chance to read this this part. And it's from October 27, 2010. But it doesn't really matter because if you haven't learned about this, well, then it's news to you, right? Says Bergen County, New Jersey, has dealt with one particular dilemma for years. The Department of Human Services needs to estimate how many homeless individuals receive services such as food, medicine, and shelter. But many people served by the department don't have accurate forms of identification, and without precise tracking systems, the DHS may have erroneously counted one person who visits the shelter 10 times, for example, as 10 different people visiting once. So, and it says, now, with biometric technology, Bergen County has implemented a solution that helps the DHS keep an accurate count of the homeless people who receive social services. In September, the DHS unveiled a fingerprint identification system developed by Fulcrum Biometrics, a San Antonio-based company. So, what is Darko's first take on this? I usually don't refer to myself in the first person, but, you know, what do I think about it? Well, I'll tell you, the only reason they're able to get away with this is because of the homeless people. And because they're receiving benefits, and if they don't, they won't receive those benefits or services from the government. So it's just the easiest way to basically condition people, but also test the technology and the infrastructure, and kind of incorporate it into government, right? These new gadgets that they have to keep track of the slaves. Well, they have to do a little isolated test, and you know, the homeless people are usually the first ones, right? Because last year, or 2 years ago now, man, time is flying, you had in the Ukraine, Baxter, I believe it was Baxter Pharmaceuticals, making flu shots and then leaving them unradiated, so they were alive of flu shots. They had some deadly virus in there. I'm not sure if it was the avian Spanish flu virus in a normal flu vaccine, but either way, it was pretty deadly, and they mixed it up by, quote, accident, and they basically paid some homeless people to take these test vaccines, and they ended up killing most of them. So, and that was, like I said, that was either in the Czech Republic or the Ukraine, but either way, we're going to move on here. Because I said I have a lot to get to. Can criticizing the boss on Facebook get you fired? And this is from the Yahoo News Upshot little blog. And says that's the question that the National Labor Relations Board is putting before an administrative law court. And it says lawyers are contending that a Connecticut-based ambulance service illegally fired an emergency medical technician after she criticized her supervisor on Facebook. The New York Times reports the case could have broad implications for workers' speech rights as applied to social media. And anything that you put on there is, you know, is going to be held against you. So anything on the internet is a public forum, so you have no privacy. And that's basically what I've gathered. I mean, just from listening to this to the CEO of Google, and various talking heads for the establishment, they basically say that you have no privacy rights, especially online. So, because it's all going into a database. All of your information with your PC, your personal computer that you paid for, that's basically a little database itself, tracks and traces all your information. You know, it all goes into a nice little DARPA database. So, big pharma to begin microchipping drugs. Big story. The age of pharmaceutical microchipping is now upon us. Novartis AG, one of the largest drug companies in the world, has announced a plan to begin embedding microchips in medications to create a, quote, smart pill technology. Oh, isn't that cute, dude? The microchip technology is being licensed from Proteus Biomedical of Redwood City, California. Once activated by stomach acid, the embedded microchip begins sensing its environment and broadcasting data to a receiver worn by the patient. I think they misspelled that, but this receiver is also a transmitter that can send the data over the internet to a doctor. So, more scary stuff. Or reason why you should not trust the medical establishment. Cookie monsters. Browser beware as political websites plant spy devices. Politicians are letting foreign-owned companies covertly gather information about voters. And it says information gathered about a user's online behavior can be used to build detailed profiles to help target advertisements, a practice many believe is a threat to privacy. In regards to advertising, yeah, that's, you know, half of it. That's 50% of it. But the other 50% goes back to what I was talking about, is as far as your all of your activity being put placed into and stored in a database, and publicly, governments in the UK and in the West admit that they are storing every text message, every phone call, every email of every citizen, but they only store it for a year. Besides advertising, the reason the government's using that is so that they can basically predict, they want you to be predictable, right? And they want to be able to predict every citizen's future behavior. What are they going to do? How predictable are they? Well, if you voluntarily give up enough information, Google searches and like all the other stuff that I was talking about, this is all going to go in your own little personal profile so that you are totally predictable wherever you go. And that's why all of the cameras, traffic cameras, all that stuff is on the expressways, that they're at intersections, all the security's at airports, it's all at railway stations. You want to know why? Because when slaves are driving about in their little cars that they don't own, you are unpredictable when you are traveling. And that's why the powers that be in the government do not like that. They don't like slaves, their property, their assets, moving about freely. That's just not what it's all about. They do give us the illusion that we have freedom, and that's kind of the more Fabianist socialist versus the Leninist control system of socialism that we're under, a more lax, not in your face type program or policy or paradigm. So that is the biggest reason why you'll see all these cameras and license plate recognition. They all say it's what for advertising, so they can target their goods and services more accurately to the consumer. But half these corporations are front for intelligence agencies. So just remember that. That's why you see it all in on the roads and everywhere in transportation, because they need to be able to control what their slaves are doing, and they want to be able to predict what they're doing. They want to have complete control over every facet of your life. So I know many listeners are aware of this, but new listeners, you need to become aware of this and realize that you are a slave, just like all of us. And the sooner you become aware and awake to this, the more you can wake up your fellow, man and woman to this information. It says, secret revealed. Spying costs $80 billion a year, the federal government has revealed how much it spends on spying. This is from the AP. The annual cost of U.S. intelligence is public for the first time, just over $80 billion for 2010. Figures released by the government Thursday show $27 billion go towards military intelligence, that's spying on people like you and I, and $53 billion covers the CIA and some of the other 16 intelligence agencies. So, need I say more? Go in there and check this article out. I gotta keep moving. There's so much tyranny and stuff that You know, I could keep talking for hours. The poop snooper, angry father of two, sets up secret cameras to catch dog owners who don't clean up their mess. A team of private detectives is working with the city council to catch dog walkers who let their pets foul the pavements. The pooper snoopers are using high-tech surveillance tactics to capture culprits who fail to bin their pets' mess. They have hidden tiny video cameras the size of thumbnails in trees and drink cans at popular dog walking sites across Milton Keynes, Buckinghamshire, in a bid to catch the offenders. So there you go, the offenders. Look at that, see? And I am a dog owner, and I do have to pick up my dog's refuse, and I think it's kind of ridiculous. I wish I had my own property where my dog didn't, I didn't have to walk my dog, but I do. I live in the city, a nice little prison area, unfortunately. And so I have to abide by the rules, and I gotta respect people's personal property. I just remember that movie though, Kate and Leopold. I just watched that recently, where an individual from the 1700s came basically into the future, and he's a very intelligent individual, and he makes the common man look like a pleb, like an idiot. Because they're so uneducated, so naive and ignorant, and just bad to each other. But that's besides the point. My point is that he was walking the dog in the beginning of the movie, and he, it was a cop. And they basically stopped him because he didn't pick up the dog's crap. And he didn't know about it. He didn't understand about walking a dog or anything like that in the city and all the rules and laws. And he's like, are you kidding? There's actually a law or an ordinance that forces me to pick up my dog's crap? You know, he just couldn't believe it. And, that's what I'm saying. That's what conditioning is. It's over a long period of time, a little at a time, implementing these crazy measures that are, 100 years ago would seem totally just moronic, right? You'd be like, get the hell out of here. What are you talking about? But that's how it works. People don't ever notice. Mental health visits rise as parents deploy. Young children and military families are about 10% more likely to see a doctor for mental difficulty when a parent is deployed than when the parent is home. Researchers are reporting Monday in the most comprehensive study to date of such families' use of health insurance during wartime. I'm a former Marine. I didn't have a wife while I was in, but I could contest to the promiscuity that goes on in there. And the military life is just horrible on families. I mean, just modern society right now is just horrible on families because the parents have to work and slave away, pay half their income to the state, and then hidden inflation and all that. And, like I said, rising costs. So they don't really have time to do the whole family thing. So they give their children over to the free child daycare, which are basically re-education camps. So, it says U.S. doctors still too cozy with drug industry, says a survey. Going to keep moving. Got a bunch left. Exclusive multiple independent lab tests confirm oil in Gulf shrimp. You're going to keep hearing conflicting reports. Panel blames oil spill on serial mistakes. We're damn straight. That was out the day that it happened, or a couple days after, BP was negligent. So, they should be charged with negligence in this because they could have prevented that whole disaster and then the core exit, which is not being talked about. All they're talking about is the oil hurting the thing, the animals. Well, what about the core exit and the water and the humans and everything else that's going to be affected by that? But they don't talk about that. It's what they don't talk about that matters. Women without kids up 80% from 30 years ago. So see, there you go. That just basically verifies what I just said, right? Modern society, we're progress, right? We're progressing. We're getting better as a society. No, we're not. We're digressing. We're getting worse. That's just my personal opinion. Look out. Your medicine is watching you. Again, this is about the spy medicine. And then you move on. Camel water contamination poisoning ignored. And moving on. Stranded cruise line passengers rescued with Spam and Pop-Tarts. This is no kidding. Next one up. Dying cancer patients subjected to expensive meaningless cancer screening. And the next one, common painkillers could be linked to male reproductive disorder. Oh, go figure, man. That's eugenics, folks. Food prices fears as U.S. warns on crop yields. And they're going to blame this on the droughts and all that. But really, it's weather modification. nothing's happens by you know, just chance. USDA plan could partially lift sugar beet. Student tuition fee protest, passive police operation results from G20 tactics change. Thank you.